Then we have the third sickness, and that is the sickness of heedlessness. And this is something pertinent to everyone in the audience today, including myself. Because shaitan, if he can't stop you from doing something good, he's willing to settle for a 50-50. It's not a win-lose for him. He's willing to settle for a 50-50. If he can't stop you praying, he will affect the quality of your prayer. If he can't stop you doing good, he'll make you forget death. So you become weak in the goodness that you do and maybe tread the path of evil. As I said, we all know about death, but we forget it. It's just like the person who drives his car on the highway and he sees the sign. What's the speed limit here? 120 kilometers? He sees the sign, 120. 100. Jazakallah khair. We have to be, I'm not encouraging people to speed. Drive at the speed limit. So the speed limit is 100 kilometers an hour and he sees the sign. And after a kilometer, he sees the sign again. And after a kilometer, he sees the sign again. Does it mean that you didn't see the first sign? No. Does it mean that the country has a lot of steel and paint? They love to paint 100, 100, 100 and stick it at every kilometer? No. They're reminding you in case you forgot. Because you know it's 100, but sometimes it's a V6 engine. You forget about it being 100. So you need to be reminded that, listen, it's a V6, but don't forget, it's 100. This is ghafla, heedlessness. We live our life in a state of heedlessness. And heedlessness is not something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about heedlessness. He says,
وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا أُولَئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, many from mankind and jinnkind have been created for the hellfire. They have hearts that physically beat, but those hearts are spiritually dead. They have eyes that physically see, but those eyes are spiritually blind. They have ears that physically hear, but those ears are spiritually deaf. La ilaha illallah. They are in a state of oblivion, in a state of heedlessness. Allah Almighty says, أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ. They are the same as cattle. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no, they worse than cattle. Because cattle have not been given the cognitive abilities that you and I have been given. Who are they? أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ. They are the heedless ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from being heedless. What causes ghafla? What causes heedlessness? Our scholars say that plenty knowledge of this world and not balancing it or beating it with knowledge of the hereafter causes ghafla. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ar-Rum, يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. They know everything about the realities of this world, but with regards to the hereafter, they're totally ignorant. They know everything about this world, and we know how science has developed. We know how science has developed. And they have found findings that when a believer hears about them, it only makes them more in awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It makes us more in awe of the Creator. But there are others who are heedless. They learn these amazing facts and it takes them even further away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.